So anyone got the answer for this? So they can tell me. I will simply write the answers and other can verify. Yes, anyone? Anyone calculated? You can speak or you can write in chat box, no problem. There you can speak or you can write in chat box. I just got some answer. Yes. Gopi has given answer. Can you put the variances? What could be their BYX? Can you write in chat box what could be your BYX? That is regression coefficient Y on X. Anyone? So as per my data, your answer could be, will be at equation y is equal to 16.3682 x plus 0.9474. I'll just this x will be longer. So on the basis of this, this we can assume this is the value of A, this is the value of B. Okay. So the regression coefficient y on x is going to be this one. And then based on this, you may get the value of, if x is equal to 10, if you substitute the value of x is here 10, you may get the value of y is going to be, just check whether you are getting this, 25.842. This is the value of y. And can anyone tell me what could be the value of r here? Is a correlation coefficient. Correlation coefficient. Anyone? Open the answer for this. Just give me 1 minute. I think Vaishali has got correct answer, which is approximate to given by me. So you can just find out whether this is match. Gopi, just check your answer whether this 23.00 is matching on. Somewhere maybe some small correction will be there. Can anyone tell me what could be the value of R here, R, if you have calculated? Please let me know. May I audible to all or not? Can you hear me, students? Yes. Go to chat box and write down why if I am audible to all. Go to chat box and write down why if I am audible to all. Only 3-6 students. Others can hear me. Okay, that means it is clear that I am audible to all. Fine, no problem. Then you should reply, na? What is your answer for correlation? Why you are not replying? I think you have not done it. Only 2 of them is replied, which is 0.38. So I'm just considering their answer. 0.30. 38 is answer getting from the participants. So you can find R square, which is simply you make it square of that. So 0.38 into 0.38. What could be your answer? I'm just multiplying.
0.1444.
Yeah. So it is 0.1444. So from this I can this is called as the coefficient of determination. What is the conclusion? I am interested on conclusion. I am not interested on numerical number. Are you getting my point? I am interested on what this coefficient of determination interprets. What is your conclusion? So 14.44% of dependent variable. What is dependent variable? Dependent variable. I will be say why. Is explained by independent variable. Which is your X. So this is the basically conclusion of Y on that is your R square. Similarly, one can compute so many problems based on that. Okay, so first let me go through that one more problem based on that, and then we can go ahead with the problem. Can you explain one more time type? What is the type? What is the type? I didn't get it. Yes, Shiva? Can you explain one dependent type? Okay. See, what it means, this coefficient of determination explained about the variability. Variability exist in your model or not, and if it is exist, then how much percent it is exist due to independent variable. So only 14% of your data, 14% of your data in dependent variable is explained by independent variable. Means I will be say the model is not good fit. If I'm saying 90 out of 100%, or if I'm saying 90% of the data in the dependent variable is explained by the independent, that means the data is like my model is a more appropriate. So this model, the model which you have created, it is more appropriate. So this is nothing but your regression model or regression equation Y on X. Okay. So this model is not good fit in this situation because our R square value is coming very less. R square value is coming very, very less. Very, very less. Are you getting my point? And hence data is not good fit. So the data which we assumed directly, it is not good fit. Okay. So that is the conclusions of your R square. Let's go to the example number 3. So I'll just take down this data, whether you can understand or not. It will time consuming, but anyways, we have to solve in the practical. So we need to be understand how to solve it. So I'm just testing whether you can able to see or not. Let me know. Can you see that table?
Yes, sir.
So go ahead with this problem. So we'll finish this problem and then we will go to the properties and equations. So how to do this example? This is exactly same type of problem which we have seen in the case of correlation. If you remember the correlation, right? So what you have to do? We need to find out x, that is your midpoint. Find out y, which is your midpoint. Okay, so if you just find midpoint, it is a 50 60 70 80. Similarly, you can find out x midpoint here, 25 35 45 and 55. Okay, I'm not going to solve entire problem. I'm just giving the idea, because these type of problems we have already seen in correlation. If you have gone through the correlation, you know properly how to solve the problem. Okay, and I have already uploaded the video also in GC, not in GC, in the YouTube. You can watch it. Okay, very soon I'm going to upload the this notes also in GC, so you can just work on that, okay? Because it is actually time consuming and that will take much time. So when you just try to use this data, and you may get all this, which is very simple for you. So x fx, the x square fx, if you remember that, then y of y. So here I'm interested to get the regression equation, because I have to estimate y, estimate sales. So my sales is y. Okay, estimate y. If my advertisement will be the x, okay, advertisement will be x, means a y on x. I'm interested y on x. So to get y on x equation, I know what are the things I've required. Y on x. So if y on x means what? I need y is equal to a plus bx. And you know what is b? B is nothing but covariance between x and y upon variance of, what is the variance of? X. Because y on x, so x is given, that's a variance of x. So that's a, to get the variance of x, you need to obtain x square f of x also. Okay, because so that's why here I have not introduced y square f of y. Can you hear? Can you understand? Y square f of y is not required. So that's why here we have calculated x square f of x, not y square f of y. Okay, so just take care of this. So whatever terms is required, first you write down the formula, and based on that you can compute the columns and terms which is required for your calculation part. And then based on that, you can calculate the remaining part. So so I am not interested on this table part. I'm interested directly the value of mean. Just anyone can tell me the value of mean, x bar, y bar, and then I will be asking for the covariance between x and y. Usual formula, so double summation xy fxy upon n.
So can you show the question?
Yeah. when you compute these values, x bar you will be get, just check, 46.25, y bar will be 60.75, and this quantity become 114050 upon 40 minus x bar y bar you have. 46.25 into 67.75. Okay, so when you calculate this, you will be get 41.5625. Similarly, you can find variance. So the variance of x is going to be, you can using the formula x square f of x upon n minus x bar square, which comes to the 75.937. And once you get that, you can find B, which is the covariance between X and Y upon variance of X. So when you just divide that two quantity, you may get the value of regression coefficient. And after simplifying that, everything, after simplifying the value, the regression equation, the regression equation y on x is given by y minus y bar b y x x minus x. Please cross check this answer whether you are getting the correct answer. So we have a y minus 60.75 is equal to 0.5473 x minus 46.25. So y will turn out to be minus 30 point. Just simplify this, you may get this answer. So this is the equation you will be getting. Can you understand this? Yes, students, can you understand this? Sachin Yadav, Sheikh, Nima, please write your roll number.
Can you show the answer, what you have got?
Yeah. Please connect with your roll number also. Just connect with your roll number.
I got 35.63 there, where you got 35.43.
Okay. And what about this B?
So B value is 0.5473.
Yeah. So B, if the B is coming same, then you should be get like 35. Because it is just multiplication, no, I think. And what about this x bar? X bar is matching. If x bar is matching, then b is also matching. Then you multiply and then you can add up with 60.
Yes, sir. I think some
x bar is 45.125.
X bar kya raha hai?
45.125.
Yes, sir. Haan, so mera bhi 47
hi aa raha hai. Yes, sir. 45.125 aa raha hai.
Yes, 45.125.
What is that total? Tell me total.
Total is 3610.
समेशन एक्स एफ
एक्स का 3.10
दिस दिस इसका टोटल समेशन एक्स एफ एक्स
यस सर उसी का 3.10
3.610 just let me just check number in the right small changes while testing. Just give me 1 minute. I will just check it. Yeah, correct. Right. So I will change a little bit here. This would be just check whether then I think I have taken something else data. That variance is coming same. The variance is also different. I will just take down that there are getting this test cross. 45.125. Y bar is 60.375. The covariance is 41.2032. The variance is that matching now? Just check. And then B will be 'Re you getting this expression now? Check it, please check it. Please check whether I think this should be the correct answer. I feel it is. It should be correct answer. Just check. If it is matching. Then go to chat box and write down why. If we have calculated and it is matching. Yes, anyone? So I got this answer. You can verify whether it is right or wrong. Okay, using that data which you have. Now, what is interpretation? What is the meaning of this particular equation which you got it? Understand. Okay, just understand. You can do the calculation part later on. Okay, just understand how it works. What is the meaning of this particular equation which you got it? If there is one unit change in independent variable, which is your x, if there is one unit change in independent variable x, then there would be increment of 0.5233 यूनिट इन डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल. आर यू गेटिंग व्हाट इज द इंटरप्रिटेशन? व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड इंक्रीमेंट? बिकॉज इट इज प्लस. It is plus 0.33. It is plus 0.33. So this the particular equation says based on the B. Okay, so B ka value you got it 0.233. If it is positive, what is the interpretation? If there is an increment of 1 unit, or if I'm substituting 1 unit in independent variable x, then there would be increment of 0.5233 in dependent variable y. If I'm changing 1 unit, if x is replaced by 1 unit, then 0.2233 increment in y. If there is no unit, then what could be your answer? If no matlab zero unit, no matlab zero unit, then my value of y will be the constant, which is 36.76. If my value is suppose negative, to kya hoga? What is your interpretation? If the value of x changes by 1 unit, then there would be decreases the value of y by 0.5233. Why it is decreases? Agar negative value hota hai, suppose mera b ka value is minus 0.5233, so mera jo y ka value hoga, that is decreases always when x will be substituted 1 unit. If my value will be 0.5233, that means the value of y will be increases. If I'm changing, my x ka unit will be 1. So what is the regression equation y on x ka physical interpretation? So physical interpretation is like this: when you change 1 unit in x, then there will be 0.5223 units change in the y. Okay, so when you change or substitute, you can say change in x by 1 unit, then value of y changes by 0.5 or increment, you can say. Or you can say changes ke badle you can put increases by 0.233. similarly, when it is negative, you can write when you change the value in x by 1 unit, then the value of y decreases by 0.23. understand, this is the very important concept, very very important. And then further, what they are saying, if my value of x is 38,000, value of x is my 38,000, what could be the value of y? So kya karo aap, 38,000 aap substitute kar do. This is not in your I can say not actually in your portion, but this is just for your knowledge. This is just for note, which is actually required for purpose of learning, worth for the learning. Writing and then doing calculation, everything can do it. You can watch any video and you can understand how can they can do the calculation. But this is the very very important. Okay. Now in question, what they ask, if it is 38,000, then what could be the value of y? You can just substitute that. I think you can get it. You just substitute the value of x will be here. It will be, just check it whether you're getting this value. So y will be given in what is the unit? This is simply given in the 100 units. So we will simply write units because we have written directly. So this much units. Just substitute it and check whether you are getting this answer.
Yes, sir. Same answer.
So only thing is that you must understand that interpretation. What is the meaning of P? So sometime it is asked in your very soon I'm going to upload. So maybe the next week, let's say 25 to 31st, you will be get the questions based on correlation. So I'm going to upload MCP questions in your GC. You have to try and do it for the practice. So just go through correlation. पूरा नोट्स जो भी है वीडियोस एंड एवरीथिंग ओके देन यू कैन जस्ट परफॉर्म फॉर द क्विज ओके सो द टेंटेटिव डेट्स फॉर क्विज विल बी 25 टू 31st ओनली वन वीक विल बी गिवन फॉर वन क्विज ओके सो देन योर क्विज विल बी स्टार्ट ऑन 25th इट विल बी स्टार्ट लेटर ऑन यू कैन नॉट एक्सेस सो विल मूव टू सम ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टीज We'll move to some of the properties. Let's say the properties of regression equation. So, what is the first property? So the first property you can write itself your regression equation. Okay, so regression equation y on x is given by y minus y bar is equal to b y x x minus x. This is the one equation, one regression equation, and similarly where B y x is nothing but covariance between x and y upon variance of x. Similarly, you can define x bar, you can define y bar. Okay, that is all you are known. So I'm just skipping that part. Similarly, you can find, you can write regression equation, and even you can define covariance between x and y. You can define variance of. Okay, so everything you can define here, which we have seen so many times. So I'm just skipping that. X and y is given by. So you can understand if you know y on x, you can very easy to find x and y. So it is going to be x minus x bar, b x y, y minus y bar. So changes kya hoga? What is your b x y, which is the covariance between x and y. And since y is given, you have to write variance of y. Okay, so again you can define everything x bar, y bar, covariance, and variance of y. So that part I'm skipping. See the few things you can understand. I'm taking a little bit fast because so far we have just completed 50% of unit one. Okay, so I don't want to like go to very fast or very slow. Okay? It will be like a medium. So this is your second property. Then we have a third property, which is usually based on some conceptual knowledge. What is that? The points x bar, y bar lies on both regression equation, okay, and it is point of intersection of two regression equations. Point of two regression इक्वेशन. सो द वैल्यू विच यू आर ऑब्टेनिंग एक्स बार वाई बार, ना मीन निकालते हो ना यूजुअली, यू फाइंड द मीन इन ऑल द केसेस लाइक दिस एक्स बार वाई बार. वॉट इज दिस? दिस इज द बेसिकली द पॉइंट ऑफ अ इंटरसेक्शन. It is basically the point of an intersection of a two regression equation. Okay. So, if you want to just study that graphically. So, if I have a data like this, this is your x, this is your y. Okay. So, this is the value of x bar, and this is the value of y bar. This is the equation of your y bar. This is the equation of x bar. So, this is the point of intersection of a. So the regression equation which you will get it, that is based on this point of intersection, and this point is basically get x bar y. So just try to understand how it works. Then we have a fourth one. You know that. What is that? B x y is nothing but covariance between x y upon variance of y. Can I write this is equal to covariance xy upon standard deviation of a y a whole square? Can I write this? Meaning is same, na?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Similarly, can I write b yx? Kya hoga? Will be covariance of xy upon standard deviation of x a whole square. Now what I'll do? See, just look at here. I am trying to write down just take a square root of b x y into b y x. Means I'm just multiplying these two coefficients. Okay, we have a it's something like you have some b, you multiply, what it interpret, what it gives, what it implies. Okay, so when you multiply, this means we are multiplying these two coefficients, right? So it would be a covariance between xy upon standard deviation y ka whole square into covariance between x and y into standard deviation a whole square. Now can you understand? What is the meaning of this? Or I may not use this square root. I will just multiply first. You will get very surprising result. If you can understand. This is b y x. This is the covariance between x and y.
No, sir.
Yes. So when you take this one, covariance into covariance, and here we have a standard deviation of x, so it is nothing but r square, right? Because covariance square, standard deviation of x has standard deviation of y, it's the square here, so it's r square. So b x y into b y x is nothing but r square. So what could be r? R is nothing
but root of bxy.
Yes, but it would be the always plus minus square root of bxy into by. Are you getting the point?
Yes, sir.
Just give me 1 minute. Yes, students, can you understand? So we got very, very interesting relation. Very, very interesting relation. What is the relation? R is equal to plus minus square root of Bxy and By. And this relation is quite useful to solving the problem. So that we will see in the maybe in the coming session. Don't worry about that. But you can understand how it works. Now, if you remember, we have seen one property. Correlation coefficient is independent of change in origin and change in the scale. Means when you do any transformation like multiplication, division, the correlation coefficient doesn't affect. But regression coefficient gets affected. Okay. So this is the result we have to understand. Don't get confused between regression coefficients and correlation coefficient. I was just putting this regression equation. We can look into that. How it. So I'm just going to give the result of this also and proof also. Okay. So this is the next result. What is the next result? Regression coefficient. Or I will just say. Effect of shift of origin and change in scale. This is a general statement. So sometime in question, in theory question, they can ask, write an effect of shift of origin and change in scale on a regression coefficient. Okay. So this is my general question. So now my question to all of you, is there is an effect of change in origin? So origin means, you know, plus minus. Or it will be effect in change in scale. Means change scale means what? Multiplication and division. Okay. So that effects we need to obtain. So how to obtain that? Okay. How to obtain that? There's a very like around 6 to 7 page line equation is there. So we will just see that if possible. Let me see somebody jump up. Yeah. So. So I will wait. I think, yeah. So I will be just take this derivation maybe in the next class. Okay, we have a next class, and then I will be going to take few more questions based on the regressions. Okay, so that we can see in the next class. And then we'll go to the curve fitting. It's a part of again correlation regression. I think who's next lecture? Yes, students.
Maths.
I think Mary Madam will join. Okay, Sanket sir. Take care. So we'll stop here only, and then because it will take time. Okay, so I will not like start and then in between we can stop. So I will be take the remaining part will be the next class. Okay, and then we will see the practical. Make sure that the students connect with their roll number with their name. Okay, because now it is going to be recorded. Okay, so. If you So I think only 29 students have connected. So they will get only attendance. That practical attendance will be only 29 students come. Okay. So make sure that that will be the condition for attending the practical. Okay. So we'll meet in the next class. So we can take a 5 minutes. Okay. Good luck.
Thank you, sir.